Every child has dreams of doing something big. Some want to be astronauts and explore new worlds. Some want to be musicians and create memorable tunes. Some want to be scientists and find cures to help and save lives. And then there are some of us that just want to climb mountains. Hello, my name is David Nelson Startzell. And when I grow up, I want to get up early one spring morning in the rain to work on this place called the Appalachian Trail. I want to become ATC life member number 460 and write and edit renewal notices for 25 years. I want to work on special trail crews, especially Lester Kenway's School of Hard Rocks. I want to speak at a lot of hiker conferences. I want to scout trails in other countries. I want to give advice to novice trail workers, the first of their kind on the trail. I want to help seekers fulfill their dreams.
Ooh. Too Many Days by Dr. Seuss.
Did I ever tell you that Mrs. McCabe had 23 sons, and she named them all Dave? Well, she did, and that wasn't a smart thing to do. You see, when she wants one and calls out, "Yoo-hoo, come into the house, Dave," she doesn't get one. All 23 Daves of hers come on the run. This makes things quite difficult at the McCaves, as you can imagine, with so many Daves, and often she wishes that when they were born, she had named one of them Bodkin Van Horn, and one of them Hoosfoos, and one of them Snim, and one of them Hotshot, and one Sunny Jim, and one of them Shadrack, and one of them Blinky, one of them Stuffy, and one of them Stinky, another one Putt-Putt, another one Moonface, another one Marvin O'Gravel Balloon Face, and one of them Ziggy, and one Soggy Muff, one Buffalo Bill, and one Biffalo Buff. And one of them Sneepy, and one Weepy Weed, and one Paris Garters, and one Harris Tweed, and one of them Sir Michael Carmichael Zut, and one of them Oliver Bolivar Butt, and one of them Zanzibar Buck Buck McFate, but she didn't do it, and now it's too late.
Dave needs to put on his boots, strap on his pack, and do a through hike. Could get him Meyer, his handiwork.
Dave Startzell should get out that photograph of himself and Bob Proudman and others at the shelter in the rain and go back to his roots and get back on the trail, because he's made more difference for the trail in a positive way than anyone else in the history of ATC.
I've got the perfect idea for what Dave Starzl should do after his retirement. He should thru-hike, and he should do it as a fundraiser for ATC. But what hoops will he have to go through to get that approved? That will keep everybody entertained until he actually steps off from, maybe he'll start from Harper's Ferry and end from Harper's Ferry and be a flip-flopper that will set the bar for all future thru-hikers. Okay, so I know this isn't original. I'm sure other people have thought of this. But I think, of course, Dave has to thru-hike. The only problem is those cigarettes are going to cost, you know, it's going to be like 3 pounds of cigarettes one day to the next. So it's either going to be, you know, quit smoking or get rid of your stove or something. Okay, Dave needs to thru-hike, and he needs to sleep with Chris.
Sounds like everybody slept with Chris.
We all have.
Well, yes.
On the trail.
Dave needs to thru-hike for sure. I'll meet him at lunchtime and give him some lunch.
Okay. The question is what Dave should do after he retires. Everybody knows he should go hike the trail. The question is, what should he do after hiking the trail? And the answer to that is very simple. Find another trail to hike. Best wishes for a long, happy, and healthy retirement.
So what should Dave do now?
He should hike the Appalachian Trail.
Can I give him a choice A and B? Okay, A is to complete a thru hike, which he'll have all the time, and B is to sail around the world on his own.
Rubber ducky. lie at a lake, get yourself something comfortable to read and drink, and do nothing.
Okay, well, what should Dave do when he retires? That's a good question. He should do whatever he wants that gives him joy, but he should definitely spend more time on the water. And when he wants to get out in his boat, he should give me a call because I'd be happy to join him.
Get the sailboat back. Sail around the world. There's no white blazes, but just go sailing.
People know this, but Dave Startzell is accident prone. So like if he goes out on a trail crew for a week, by Thursday he'll have crushed his finger or put an axe in his ankle and be at the emergency room, you know, getting sewn up by some country doctor to put in a cast. So, what should Dave do for his retirement? He should be careful. I don't know, maybe he should be a lobbyist for the environment. He was good at that. We want to keep him involved. But he definitely shouldn't be doing trail work.
Dave, like I told you, you should do the amazing race.
Perhaps I should
be great. I'll be your partner.
Someone else,
be great.
And I think that Dave should go into farming, free-range tofu.
Carolina, all you can eat barbecue restaurant.
Yes.
People who have a hard time expressing themselves, I think Dave would make a great email ghostwriter for future leaders.
That given all of the expertise and talent that he has, I think it's time that Dave goes out and gets a job that'll pay him what he's truly worth.